Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can find out sum of even and odd elements separately of a matrix by passing 2D array into a function. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the URL youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app TechMS, which is available on Google Play. Now coming on to the topic. Here I will be implementing the solution of this problem with the help of C programming. So first I am including a header file, that is stdio.h. Now I am declaring a function void sum, then int, and dimension of 2D array is 3x3. So this statement is function declaration. So here return type of function is void, name of function is sum, and it will receive a 2D array of integer type as argument. After that, I am defining main function. Inside main function, first I am declaring a 2D array, then ij variables. Now with the help of printf, the message enter elements will be displayed on console. To receive elements from user, I am implementing nested loops. So first loop is I, which will provide row indexes, and second loop is j, which will provide column indexes. Now I am repeating scanf statement with these nested loops so that elements of 2D array can be stored at different indexes. After completion of reading process, I can call sum function and I am passing 2D array inside it. So this statement is function calling and then return 0. So return type of sum function is void, that's why it will not receive any argument from the function definition. So after implementation of main function, I am defining definition of sum function. So this block will be known as function definition. Inside this function, I am declaring some variables. So here s1 and s2 variables are initialized with 0. Now again I am implementing nested loops so that I can access elements available at different indexes. So I will be providing row indexes and j will be providing column indexes. Now I am applying a if condition. Here I am checking whether array element which is available at aij position is divisible by 2 or not. So if array element is divisible by 2, then it is even element, otherwise it is odd element. So I am applying this notation. S1 equals to S1 plus aij. So aij element will be added into S1 if it is even. Now else, if it is odd, then it will be added into S2. So this is the complete implementation of this nested loop. Again, you can see if aij is divisible by 2, then aij will be added into S1, otherwise it will be added into S2. After completion of these nested loops, we can print the sum on console with the help of this printf. So even sum equals to %d, then slash n odd sum equals to %d, then s1 comma s2. So this way complete definition of sum function is implemented in front of you. Now I am going to execute this program so that we can check the output. So you can see I have entered 9 elements. So now count how many elements are even. So 2, 2, 2. Only 3 times I have entered even value. So even sum is 6. Now odd elements are 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So 6 times I have entered 1. So odd sum is 6. So the program is working properly. It is showing the correct results. So this way I have passed a 2D array into function so that I can find out sum of even and odd elements separately. I hope you have understood how I have implemented this code. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the URL youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app TechMS that is available on Google Play. Thank you for watching this video.